Therefore, I acknowledge my faults, and my sin is ever before me. Dearly beloved, the scriptures teach us to acknowledge our many sins and offenses, not concealing them from our Heavenly Father, but confessing them with humble and obedient hearts, that we may obtain forgiveness by His infinite goodness and mercy. We ought at all times humbly to acknowledge our sins before Almighty God, but especially when we come together in His presence, to give thanks for the great benefits we have received at His hands, to declare His most worthy praise, to hear His holy word, and to ask for ourselves and on behalf of others those things which are necessary for our life and our salvation. Therefore, draw near with me to the throne of heavenly grace. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways of our sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess your faults. Restore all those who are penitent according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed. Now as we come to the setting of the sun and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. Hear my teaching, O my people. Incline your ear to the words of my mouth. I will open my mouth in a parable. I will utter dark sayings of old, which we have heard and known, and such as our forefathers have told us, that we should not hide them from the children of the generations to come, but show the honor of the Lord, his mighty and wonderful works that he has done. He made a covenant with Jacob and gave Israel a law, which he commanded our forefathers to teach their children, that their posterity might know it, and the children which were yet unborn, with the intent that when they came up, they might show it to their children, that they might put their trust in God and not forget the works of God, but keep his commandments and not be as their forefathers, a faithless and stubborn generation, a generation that did not set their heart aright and whose spirit did not cleave steadfastly to God. Like the children of Ephraim, archers carrying bows who turned back in the day of battle. They did not keep the covenant of God and would not walk in his law, but forgot what he had done and the wonderful works that he had shown them, marvelous things he did in the sight of our forefathers and in the land of Egypt, even in the field of Zoan. He divided the sea and let them go through. He made the waters to stand in a heap. In the daytime he led them with a cloud, and all the night through with a light of fire. He split the hard rocks in the wilderness and gave them drink in abundance, as out of the great deep. He brought waters out of the stony rock so that it gushed out like the rivers. Yet for all this they sinned more against him and provoked the Most High in the wilderness. They tested God in their hearts and demanded food for their craving. They spoke against God, saying, "Can God prepare a table in the wilderness?" Indeed, he smote the stony rock so that the water gushed out in the stream and the streams overflowed. But can he give bread also or provide meat for his people? When the Lord heard this, he was full of wrath. So fire was kindled against Jacob, and there flared up fierce anger against Israel, because they did not believe in God and did not put their trust in his help. So he commanded the clouds above and opened the doors of heaven. He rained down manna upon them to eat and gave them food from heaven. So mortals ate the bread of angels, for he sent them food enough. He caused the east wind to blow in the heavens, and through his power he brought in the south wind. He rained meat upon them as thick as dust, and feathered fowl like the sand of the sea. Let it not fall among their tents, even round about their habitations. He let it fall among their tents and even round their habitations, so they ate and were well fed. For he gave them what they desired. They did not deny themselves their cravings. But while the food was yet in their mouths, the heavy wrath of God came upon them and slew the mightiest of them and struck down the young men of Israel. But for all this they sinned yet more and did not believe his wondrous works. Therefore he brought their days to an end in vanity and their years in trouble. When he slew them, they sought him, and returned, and inquired after God, and they remembered that God was their rock, and the Most High God was their Redeemer. Nevertheless, they flattered him with their mouth, and spoke deceitfully to him with their tongue. For their heart was not fixed on him, neither did they continue steadfast in his covenant. But he was so merciful that he forgave their iniquities and did not destroy them. Indeed, many times he turned his wrath away and would not permit his displeasure to arise. For he considered that they were but flesh, that they were even as the wind that passes away and comes not again. Many times they provoked him in the wilderness and grieved him in the desert. They turned back and tested God and provoked the Holy One of Israel. They remembered not his power, not the day, nor the day when he delivered them from the land, from the hand of the enemy. How he had wrought his miracles in Egypt and his wonders in the field of Zoan. He turned their waters into blood so that they might not drink of the waters. He sent flies among them which devoured them up and frogs to destroy them. He gave their food to the grasshopper and their labor to the locust. He destroyed their vines with hailstones and their sycamore trees with the frost. He smote their cattle also with hailstones and their flocks with hot thunderbolts. He cast upon them the furiousness of his anger, his wrath, anger, displeasure, and trouble, sending these destroying angels among them. He made a way for his indignation and did not spare their soul from death, but gave their life over to the pestilence and smote all the firstborn of in Israel, the first fruits of their strength in the dwellings of Ham. But as for his own people, he led them forth like sheep and carried them in the wilderness like a flock. He brought them out safely and did not, and they were not afraid. He overwhelmed their enemies with the sea and brought them within the borders of his holy land to his mountain, which he obtained with his right hand. He cast out the nations before him and caused their land to be delivered among them for an inheritance, and made the tribes of Israel to dwell in their tents. But they tested and displeased the Most High God and did not keep his testimonies, but turned their backs and fell away like their forefathers, twisting aside like a broken arrow. For they grieved him with their hill altars and provoked him to displeasure with their images. When God heard this, he was full of wrath and utterly rejected Israel, so that he forsook the tabernacle in Shiloh, even the tent that he had pitched among them. He delivered the ark into captivity and his glory into the enemy's hand. He gave his people over to the sword and was angry with his inheritance. Fire consumed their young men, and their maidens had no marriage songs. Their priests were slain with the sword, and their widows made no lamentation. Then the Lord awakened as one out of sleep, and like a warrior recovered from wine, he drove his enemies backward and put them to a perpetual shame. He rejected the tabernacle of Joseph and did not choose the tribe of Ephraim, but chose the tribe of Judah, even the hill of Zion, which he loved. And there he built a sanctuary like the heights of heaven, like the heaven which he had established forever. He chose David his servant, and took him away from the sheepfolds. As he was following the ewes that were great with young, God took him that he might feed Jacob and his people, to feed Jacob his people and Israel his inheritance. So he fed them with a faithful and true heart, and guided them with skillful hands. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Reading from the book of Ecclesiastes, beginning with the first chapter, the first verse. The words of the preacher, the son of David, king in Jerusalem. Futility of futilities, says the preacher. Futility of futilities. All is futility. What advantage does a person have in all his work which he does under the sun? A generation goes and a generation comes, but the earth remains forever. Also the sun rises and the sun sets, and hurrying to its place, it rises there again, blowing toward the south, then turning toward the north. The wind continues swirling along, and on its circular courses, the wind turns. All the rivers flow into the sea, yet the sea is not full. The place where the river flows, where the rivers flow, there they flow again. All things are wearisome. No one can tell it. The eye is not satisfied with seeing, nor is the ear filled with hearing. What has been, it is what will be. And what has been done, it is what will be done. So there is nothing new under the sun. Is there anything of which one might say, see this, it is new? It has already existed for ages which were before us. There is no remembrance of the earlier things and of the later things as well which will occur. There will be no remembrance of them among those who will come later still. I, the preacher, have been king over Israel in Jerusalem, and I set my mind to seek and explore by wisdom about everything that has been done under the sun. By wisdom about everything that has been done under heaven. It is a sorry task with which God has given the sons of mankind to be troubled. I have seen all that the works which have been done under the sun. And behold, all is futility and striving after wind. What is crooked cannot be straightened, and what is lacking cannot be counted. I said to myself, behold, I have magnified and increased wisdom more than all who were over Jerusalem before me. And my mind has observed a wealth of wisdom and knowledge. And I applied my mind to know wisdom and to know insanity and foolishness. I realized that this also is striving after wind, because in much wisdom there is much grief. And increasing knowledge results in increasing pain. This is the word of Allah. Thanks be to God. I will sing to the Lord, for he is lofty and uplifted. The horse and its rider he has hurled into the sea. The Lord is my strength and my refuge. The Lord has become my savior. This is my God, and I will praise him, the God of my people, and I will exalt him. The Lord is a mighty warrior. The Lord is his name. The chariots of Pharaoh and his army he has hurled into the sea. The finest of those who bear armor have been drowned in the Red Sea. The fathomless deep has overwhelmed them. They sank into the depths like a stone. Your right hand, O Lord, is glorious in might. Your right hand, O Lord, is overthrown the enemy. Who can be compared with you, O Lord, among the gods? Who is like you, glorious in holiness, awesome in renown, and worker of wonders? You stretched forth your right hand, the earth swallowed them up. With your constant love, you led the people you redeemed. You brought them in, and you brought them in safety to your holy dwelling. You will bring them in and plant them on the mount of your possession, the resting place you have made for yourself, O Lord, the sanctuary, O Lord, that your hand has established. The Lord shall reign forever and forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the first epistle of St. John, beginning with the third chapter, the first verse. See how great a love the Father has given us, that we would be called children of God, and in fact we are. For this reason, the world does not know us, because it does not know Him. Beloved, now we are children of God, and it has not appeared as yet what will. And it has not appeared as yet what we will be. We know that when He appears, He will be like Him, because we will see Him just as He is. And everyone who has this hope set on Him. And everyone who has this hope set on Him purifies himself just as He is pure. Everyone who practices sin also practices lawlessness, and sin is lawlessness. You know that He appeared in order to take away sins, and in Him there is no sin. No one who remains in Him sins continually. No one who sins continually has seen Him or knows Him. Little children, make sure no one deceives you. The one who practices righteousness is righteous, just as He is righteous. The one who practices sin is of the devil, for the devil has been sinning from the beginning. The Son of God appeared for this purpose, to destroy the works of the devil. No one who has been born of God practices sin, because his seed remains in him, and he cannot sin continually, because he has been born of God. By this, the children of God and the children of the devil are obvious. Anyone who does not practice righteousness is not of God, nor the one who does not love his brother or sister. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Lord, now let your servant depart in peace according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles, and to be the glory of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Amen. That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful, we entreat you, Lord, that your holy angels may lead us in paths of peace, of goodwill. And goodwill, we entreat you, O Lord, that we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offenses. We entreat you, O Lord, that there may be peace in your church and in the whole world. We entreat you, O Lord, that we may depart this life in your faith and fear, and not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ. We entreat you, O Lord. Almighty God, whose Son Jesus Christ is, in his earthly life, shared our toil and hallowed our labor, Be present with your people where they work. Make those who carry on the industries and commerce of this land responsive to your will. And give us all a right satisfaction in what we do and a just return for our labor. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. O God, you have prepared for those who love you such good things as surpass our understanding. Pour into our hearts such love towards you that we, loving you in all things and above all things, may obtain your promises, which exceed all that we can desire, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, the source of all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works, give to your servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey your commandments, and that we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen. O God and Father of all, whom the whole heavens adore, let the whole earth also worship you, all nations obey you, all tongues confess and bless you, and men, women, and children everywhere love you and serve you in peace, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Alleluia. Alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit.